Hi there. It's Mary Jo. It is sometime in March. March 11th, 2023. It's been a minute, hasn't it? I don't know about you, but the full moon in Virgo and Saturn's transit into Pisces really was an amazing experience for me, but it required me to pull my energy back and really integrate some things. And I'm still not there yet, but I just really wanted to come on and do a reading. So I'm here. I hope everyone is doing so well. It's amazing. It is amazing. I have no, I just don't have my bearings in the new that has presented itself to me. So, higher consciousness, connection with my galactic self. I mean, it's just, I mean, I've known she's been in there, I've known it's been in there, whatever it is. It really took me by surprise, and it came in a very unexpected package, in a sense. So I mean, it's just so much. It's just so much to take in, to process, to integrate. But I'll get there. I know that. So today, I just wanted to come on and do a reading. Plain simple. Just wanted to do a reading. Just wanted to pull some energies. I have a feeling. I have a feeling of what's gonna come through, but let's just see. So I have here my soul lesson cards by James Van Praagh and Soul Journeys lesson cards. Let me rephrase that. A very odd bunch of decks that requested their presence on my table today. So it'd be interesting what message wants to come out. So let's get going, huh? Divine Mother, Divine Father, strongest messages or message, whatever you have for us, for those watching. What is the soul lesson here? Wow. Forgiveness, ooh, and blame. Forgiveness says, I acknowledge that harboring resentment blocks the flow of love, and blame says, I accept responsibility for my well-being. I love the colors in these because they kind of interact for me with the orange here, pulling the orange into this card and the blue pulling everything together. Yeah, this is a solo journey. We are no longer in a space of pointing the fingers and saying, well, you know, if you had done this, or if they had ever, you know, did this or would say this or whatever. It doesn't matter. This is your journey. This is your journey. It's also your journey. Just stop beating yourself up. Forgive yourself for things you didn't know in the past, because you weren't meant to. You weren't at a conscious level, you know, that you're at now. I just feel real strongly to say, stop beating yourself up over something you didn't know, something you didn't recognize, something, whatever it was, whatever it is for you. Time to forgive yourself, time to forgive others. And forgiveness isn't about them. Remember, this is all about you. All about you. No blaming God, no blaming anything outside of you. Just lighting my sage again. Been doing this a lot, needing more and more sage in my space. Even though I'm the only one here, things that I'm clearing, things that I'm integrating, things that are leaving, releasing, just all needs to constantly have a cleansing. Let's tap into the tarot. Forgiveness. Letting go of grudges, you know. I've got this really energy coming through. Like somebody doesn't want to. Somebody doesn't want to. Divine Mother, Divine Father, what is this? What are you trying to say to us? Whose message is this? Ooh, 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 ooh. Yeah, Ten of Coins could have to do with a family situation. Could have to do with family members. Your abundance, how you support your family. Let's see, what else, please, Spirit? But we're going to take them. Oh, they're beautiful cards. Got the moon, got judgment, and you've got the Ace of Swords. This is fully, I'm really receiving a strong message here with the judgment and this forgiveness and blame. This is about seeing yourself clearly with the Ace of Swords. This is reconciling with yourself about anything that you've been hiding, resisting, holding back, something that's very deeply seated within you. Could be something very emotional that you've moved through in the past. Really picking up on, even though, you know, these the wolf and the dog, they're from the same family. But there's a duality coming off of this card for me today. And this is just coming into clarity, coming into a full knowledge and understanding and awareness of this within yourself, this duality within yourself, this shadow aspects, these hidden aspects of yourself coming to light, having full vision and clear vision of what that is. For some, it could be who you were in a family dynamic, who you always presented yourself to be, who you were expected to present yourself to be, I'm hearing for some. And really, finally, seeing the truth of that with this, it's just really seeing the truth of that. I think I want to get more on that, please, Spirit. This Ten of Pentacles, yeah, this Ten of Pentacles and this Ace of Swords are really speaking to me. So let's, I think the Moon and the Judgment, we really got a full understanding of that. Thank you. I feel I need one more Moon Spirit. Junwa, they say. Nine of Coins, Star, and Three of Cups. So we've got the nine and ten of coins. Progression, healing with the Star. I'm getting the reconciling with the Three of Cups in the Judgment. They're both speaking to me today, but reconciling with something, an emotional aspect. With the masks here, it's really fully seeing your place in a dynamic, really fully seeing not even just in a dynamic, but in the world, you know, in the Star. I mentioned my galactic aspects of self coming forward, and this is really speaking to that for me. Yeah, it just with the Ace of Swords and the Star, it's just really seeing your having clarity of who you are on a higher level. Having healed aspects of self, having healed, you know, the duality within and the dark, the things that were hidden in the depths and the darkness of yourself, really coming into full judgment, seeing yourself clearly, being reborn, being reconciled with self. Interesting. See how the sword is kind of woven in this triangle here. It goes behind and then it goes in front of. I hope it makes sense for you. What I heard was seeing how you, aspects of you are woven into your experience. That's not how I want to say that. Yeah, it is. Seeing how everything, the shadow aspects that we've healed, the wounds that we've healed, the judgment we've had on ourselves, the blame we've pointed toward others and ourselves, the forgiveness, all of it has, all of it's interconnected and it's interwoven. That's, to me, that's a no duh statement coming out of my mouth. But now it's like really fully seeing how all the pieces fit together, really seeing yourself, really seeing how abundant you are, really seeing how much value you have in your experience, in this world, in connections, in family dynamics, whatever this is for you. I want more. I always want more. Without spirit. Those watching. Queen of Cups coming into your divine understanding, your divine knowing of self. Trusting your intuition. Having closed out cycles. With the Death card on the bottom, the Empress. Yeah, really coming into your own, it feels like. And it's come at a cost of, or not at a cost, at, yes, at a cost. A cost of losing the old self. A cost of, instead of projecting outward, really taking a look at the self. And knowing that anything in your life that felt like it was not moving or butting heads against where your soul was nudging you to, whatever, I mean, it's really about, gosh, I get the best way I can say it, is just really unearthing all those aspects of self that were standing in the way of the forward movement, of the awareness, of the knowledge, of the breakthroughs, of the clarity. And once that was removed, the healing definitely took place. I mean, she's right in the center of my table here, of the spread that I've how spirit has had me lay these out. This healing has occurred for many of us. It's, you know, it was about coming into financial abundance, you know, discipline with our finances, you know, for others, for all of us, or whatever. It could be the clarity that came in, the breakthroughs that came in, the intuition that was awakened. Anything else, Spirit? I'm hearing three more cards. And there they are. Yeah. Yeah. This is, you know, King of Coins and the Five of Swords. This is just removing things from your belief systems, your surroundings, things that just didn't serve you anymore. Standing firmly on your own, coming fully into self. Magician. What did I say in the beginning? This is a solo journey. Let me see. The only card that's got multiple energies in it, other than the moon with the wolf and the dog, I've got the judgment with the other aspects of self, it feels like, that are being, those that don't serve you are being up, you know, lifted up and out and reconciled with and forgiven and healed. And then on another aspect of that, there's the real aspects, the true aspects of self are being remembered. They're being pulled up into your consciousness now to be fully seen with such clarity, such sharpness of vision. I'm hearing, magician, you can create anything you want with this new knowledge using the elements. This is someone who is also, or aspects of ourselves, or all of us, and whoever I'm speaking to, that has learned to, I don't want to say use the energies, the elements, the energies of the elements, but it's a, I don't know what word it would be best for me to slip in there, instead of not use, it's to work with, to merge with the elements and the energies within and without themselves, and to really create and manifest whatever your freaking heart desires, man. This is beautiful. It's strong. You know, King of Coins, Queen of Cups is kind of like balancing the energies of the masculine and the feminine within. You know, the masculine is the provider, the security, the stability that we provide for ourselves. It's the one that takes action. You know, it grounds things into the earthly plane. And the feminine energy is the intuition, the higher knowledge, and the inner knowing. And it's blending the two together. It's blending it all together to create something incredibly beautiful. And it all starts with facing this. You know, it's, healing the wounds that have kept us stagnant, that have kept us in fear. You know, the moon, it keeps us in fear, things that are hidden. We don't want to look at it. We're button heads. We're at, you know, we're fighting each other, or fighting ourselves within. But when we can surrender and release and let go of anything that's standing in our way, it opens us up to a new creation. It opens up us up to... It's amazing how... I know you can't see these cards. How... I don't know if that's not going to help. Spirit had me lay these down. On this side of the table, I've got the Ten of Pentacles, the Nine of Pentacles, and the King of Pentacles. I've got the masculine energy within us. And then on this side of my table, I've got the Star, the Ace of Swords, the Queen of Cups, the Magician. You know, it's the judgment. It's the ethereal. It's the soul. It's the higher aspects of self. And it comes together. The Star comes together in the center, and it blends it all. Wow. One more card, please, Spirit. Then we'll get a secret language of light card for our guidance. One more card. What else can you tell me about this? This is a beautiful journey. Journey that's been done solo, the hermit. This journey that has been done quite possibly in isolation. Even if we move amongst the world, we go and we do our daily job. You know, we interact with others. We're still on that solo journey, aren't we? For some, it was about really pulling back the energy. Just like I said in the beginning, I needed to pull my energy back this week because I had something just incredible. A remembering of who I was and aspects of my lower self, which I thought I had healed. You know, we're never done healing, are we? But the lower aspect of myself was like, I don't know how to wrap my head around that. You know, I don't know how to see myself in the light that I was shown that I am, if that makes sense. So I needed to pull myself back. I needed to reserve my energy. I needed to give to self more. I needed to sit with myself. I needed to sit with my heart. I needed to commune with God and with Source and my angels and the universe. And I'm still in this mode, even though I'm here doing a video. It almost feels like I'm never gonna leave this mode. And that's a good thing because I can quickly go back and even in the chaos, I can quickly go back and get in touch with this higher aspect of me. You know, this is for all of us. This is about reserving our energy, protecting our energy, going within. Excuse me. Clearing the throat chakra, speaking some truth to yourself, forgiving yourself. This is about the healing. This is about gaining wisdom. This is about surrendering and allowing to see the true aspects of yourself, no matter what they are. Remember, those true aspects can even be, you know, when we're on the healing journey, those true aspects can be, oh my gosh, I can't believe I was that type of person in that situation. It's about forgiving self. It's, you know, whatever you don't like. I mean, you're not that person. Whatever you don't like, you can change that. You can set the intention to be better, to do better, to be the higher version of yourself. And this is what this reading is saying to me. It's about the journey of the higher aspects of self really coming into the highest version of you. And it starts with the healing. It starts with the forgiveness. It starts with understanding that okay, Spirit is saying it starts with the understanding that there really isn't anything to forgive. That just flipped the things on its head, huh? There isn't. It's all part of the soul plan. It's your soul contract. There was never a mistake. Okay, so the human might need to look back and say, all right, I understand. I forgive. I feel it's more of a human aspect that forgives. The soul never has to forgive. There isn't anything to forgive. It understands that everything happened as it was, as it should have, as it was meant to, as it was agreed upon, Spirit is saying. You know, we agree to this journey. We agree to whatever experience we've experienced moving, you know, up to this point. And some of us have chosen some pretty gnarly journeys to be on, haven't we? And I don't mean gnarly as in cool dude. I mean challenging, traumatic, soul-wrenching journeys that have cracked us open, that have given us many opportunities to see the aspects that aren't us, the aspects that work, human conditioning, that they were learned, they were programmed in, however you want to view it. Opportunities to release all of that, to surrender to the divine plan and to the healing that's meant to take place. I'm hearing with this, be your own guru. That's kind of like a deja vu. I don't know if I said that in my last reading or not, but that feels very familiar to me coming out of my mouth. You're the only one that can do your path for you. You do it in conjunction, in communion with the divine, and you light the way for others, but you can't do that for them. You know, it's not something that we don't know already, right? Beautiful journey of self. Myself, I can see myself here. Can you see yourself in this reading? This beautiful message from Spirit. I'm hearing with this moon card, if I can pick it up, you know, the waterfall in the center there, I'm hearing you have been washed clean. You have been washed clean. Transformation has occurred. With the, well, this is an extended message here. I mean, it just keeps going. With the Hermit and the Magician, I am getting a sense of a leadership role here for some. I mean, maybe for all of us. I mean, we're all light workers, aren't we? We're here to learn how to do this for ourselves so we can take our knowledge, take our wisdom, and light the way for others. Teach others how to do this for themselves by finding their own path and their own way of working with the elements, of merging the elements. Leading others to their truth, showing them the way back to themselves. This is getting deeper and deeper as I go here. Full balance of the masculine and feminine energy within. Mastery over the thoughts. Mastery over the pentacles, how you know, the discipline over the finances. Mastery over the emotions with the Queen of Cups. Solid. Grounded yet able to flow with the energies. Just I'm just surprised I don't have like the Temperance or the Justice card out. You know, that it just feels like a very divine balance of energies here. And with this Hermit, I'm just feeling so serene and so peaceful with this Hermit card in the center. Well, I don't know about you, but I needed this reading. Wow. All right. Secret Language of Light Oracle. I will read the message out of the book. I want one more. That's beautiful. One more, please. Thank you. Okay. First one we have is healing. I'll show you the card in a moment. Be illuminated by love and truth. Right now, healing is taking place to support your understanding of the gifts in your experiences. Weird or difficult circumstances can often be a fast-track path to your desires. Until we recognize subtle imbalances, the best way to clean up outdated beliefs is to have our buttons pushed. Buttons are created by continued attention to unbalanced thoughts, ideas, and beliefs. Every time we are reminded of or talk about a hurt, it pushes a button and reopens a wound that we are yet to heal. Wounds are created by mental, spiritual, or physical trauma. Poking at them will prolong the healing process. Leave them alone so balance can be restored and wholeness can return. Inspired action for healing may include seeing a therapist, consulting a medical professional, or spending time in the ocean. Focusing on what you love is also healing. All is perfect in every moment, even if we can't see it at the time. I feel so many of us are coming out of this healing cycle. Oh, God bless you, Fidget. Fidget's on the couch with me. She's never too far away when I'm doing a reading. I love that. I love it. And if her daddy is watching, that would be pretty awesome too. But yeah, healing. We are definitely, look at that. I mean, just look at that. Look at that beautiful energy, that light. Being in the hermit mode brings so much healing. Wow, I needed this reading very much so. The healing card was number 5. That might be significant for some. And this card, number 34, which reduces to a 7, of course, might be significant. Soul mating. Isn't that beautiful? I don't think I've ever seen this card come out for me before. This is the first time I'm using this deck on the channel, so that's beautiful. Okay. Embrace your soul to reveal a partner. Being in communion with self. A new encounter or a deepening of an already existing union will profoundly change the way you perceive unconditional love. I feel I need to say, for those of you on the twin flame path, this is for you. Doesn't have to be. You don't have to be on that path for this message to resonate. But, you know, if you are. Chemistry between two people does not mean they are life partners. They have entered each other's life to awaken, expand, and open your hearts so wide that they may never close again. It may last for a moment, a season, or a lifetime. Time is not necessary to shift the cogs of your heart and feel the absolute ecstasy of you. A moment can open you to euphoria. The purpose of a soul relationship is to mirror your love and light and melt away any hard edges or walls you have built. Oh, this is perfect. Whatever is mirrored will intensify. Love and peace will feel bigger. The soul will fear and pain. Let me read that again. Whatever is mirrored will intensify. Love and peace will feel bigger, but so will fear and pain. This reveals any wounds that hold us away from love, so we can heal them as we embrace more of the love we already recognize. Yes, exactly what I meant, what I said here. Releasing the aspects of ourselves, the love, the pain, facing it all, releasing everything that doesn't serve us anymore. And when we do that, it really reveals to us our truth. Our truth, who we really are. Who are we? Our truth. We are the magician. We are the hermit. We are the star. We're all of it. We're everything and nothing at all. We are everything and nothing at all. Interesting. I feel a big communion with self here. Those of us on the twin flame journey, we know that meeting the soul partner was a cracking open of the soul. It was the journey back to self, the journey back to unconditional love, the journey back home. Yeah. Beautiful. Well, I hope this message finds you well. I really needed to hear these messages. I mean, it's exactly, for me, it's right where I am. I just feel like so much more can be said here, but I'm going to leave it. I'm going to leave it. I'll speak to you soon. I love you. I love you so much. I hope you're well. We'll speak soon.